Throughout the 1950s and 60s, there was a significant effort to understand DNA's role in the cell. In 1961, American biochemist Marshall Nirenberg demonstrated that RNA drove amino acid into protein. A year later, he showed oligoribonucleotides comprising only of uracil drive only phenylalanine into protein, and those comprising of cytosine drove proline into protein. It became apparent that specific combinations of RNA bases encoded for amino acids. Having established nucleotides were read in triplets, Nirenberg and his team began synthesizing and testing all 61 possible trinucleotide permutations for the amino acids they encoded. The codons he found for each of the 20 amino acids were published in 8 consecutive papers from 1964 to 1966, earning Nirenberg the 1968 Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine. Following this, the nature of the genetic code itself began to raise further questions. Out of the 64 possible codons, only 61 encoded one of 20 amino acids. Nirenberg also observed that groups of 2, 3, or 4 codons often encoded the same amino acid, rendering much of the genetic code redundant, similar to how multiple words in the English language have the same meaning. This redundancy was not random either, as synonymous codons only varied in their last nucleotide and followed 3 main patterns of redundancy. Those ending in C were generally synonymous with those ending in U, those ending in A were generally synonymous with those ending in G, or all 4 were synonymous with each other. Furthermore, Nirenberg's colleague Robert Holley and others demonstrated synonymous codons often bound the same tRNA molecule, implicating base pairing between tRNA and codon nucleotide in the third position did not follow normal pairing rules. Having devised the original rules for pairing, molecular biologist Francis Crick took great interest in understanding this unconventional interaction, proposing the Wobble hypothesis as a possible explanation in 1966. In his manuscript, Codon-Anticodon Pairing, the Wobble Hypothesis, Crick suggested that the first tRNA anticodon base, which interacts with the third codon base, wobbled in 3D space, allowing it to form unconventional pairs alongside those permitted by Watson and Crick pairing. Aside from the usual AUGC base pairing, Crick suggested that the third nucleotide might also observe those between G and A, C and U, U and U, G and U, I and U, or I and A. Through evaluating each possibility, Crick disqualified G and A, as it was unable to form sufficient hydrogen bonding, and both U and C and U and U due to hindrance from glycosidic bonds and keto groups. Contrastingly, he deemed G and U, I and U, I and A pairings possible, as they could form necessary hydrogen bonds and didn't require wobbling far from the standard position. Crick then evaluated possible codon-anticodon positions needed to enable these interactions, finding 7 in total, although noting all 7 are unlikely considering geometrical constraints during transcription. He then disqualified any pairings which went against the general features of the code, such as enabling multiple amino acids to be encoded by one codon. This left a total of 4 positions including that of the standard base pairing, and so 6 total combinations. For these rules to hold, Crick made several general assumptions about the anticodon sequences of any tRNA. 1. There existed no tRNAs which can recognize A or C in the codon's third position alone. 2. If one amino acid's codons end in G and C and another ends in A and U, given both share the first 2 same nucleotides, neither can possess a tRNA with ionazine in the last position, as this would bind to both amino acid's codons. And 3. If one amino acid has 4 codons, there needs to be at least 2 tRNAs which carry it, as no base can recognize all 4 bases. To date, no tRNA anticodon has ever been found which challenges these assumptions. As the first comprehensive guide to third position anticodon-codon interaction, the Wobble hypothesis has had a profound effect on the entire field of genetics, and continues to allow predictions of the number and structure of possible tRNAs in organisms. With Wobble pairing, the minimum number of distinct tRNA anticodons needed by an organism is 32. In reality, the lowest number observed is 36, possessed by Archaea methanococcus genasii. Comparatively, flies have 44 and humans 51. This variation in tRNA numbers is in part due to preferential use of particular synonymous codons over others. This codon bias varies by organism, and its purpose is an active field of research. In more complex organisms, selective pressure for increased translation, efficiency, and accuracy is believed to be a reason for this favoring of some codons, but much is still unknown. While we may never fully understand the purpose of Wobble pairing, Crick's Wobble hypothesis is a fundamental advancement in the field of genetics and continues to help us uncover the nature of life itself.